E aí, pessoal, tudo bem? No final de agosto, eu viajei com a família para Orlando, nos Estados Unidos, para passear nos parques, coisa e tal. Só que eu aproveitei para ir conhecer uma loja especializada em corrida de rua, que é algo muito tradicional por lá. Então, fui conhecer a Track Shack. O Track Shack foi fundado em 1977 e eles também organizam provas, como a Maratona da Disney, por exemplo, que é bem conhecida da gente, os brasileiros, né? A loja é tocada pelo John e pela Betsy Hughes. Eles fazem parte do Hall da Fama da corrida dos Estados Unidos e eu entrevistei os dois. O que você vai assistir agora é a entrevista que eu fiz com o John. O John não acha grande coisa ter feito 2 horas e meia em maratona, acredite se quiser. Bom, ele vai falar sobre o crescimento da corrida de rua nos Estados Unidos, o crescimento dos participantes de competições, né, das provas por lá também, e vai falar também sobre ter batido na porta lá da Disney para oferecer essa maratona que é um grande sucesso hoje em dia. So, John, when Track Shack got involved into making races, organizing events?
Yes, we got into it a year after Track Shack opened. The Track Shack retail store opened in 1977, and in 1978 we started putting on races, mainly just to promote the store and to promote the sport, get people into running. And then by the early 80s we already had a running series, which we called the Grand Prix back then. And we started with like 4 races in 1978. And then by 1980, we had about a dozen races. And then moving forward into the 80s, by the end of the 80s, we had about 40 races
Okay.
that we were involved with in some way or producing.
So, did you imagine that the races could be so big now, right now, like you see in US?
Never. Not in my wildest dreams. You know, there had been different running booms. The one that started, you know, back in the late 70s, particularly after Frank Shorter won the marathon, you know, in Munich, and, you know, suddenly running became more popular, but still it was very, very small.
Hey, you got Frank Shorter, you got Nike, you
All,
got
yes,
it
and
was a
all that was happening in the 70s.
yeah.
But what was not happening was it was still 85% male and only 15% female. And that was huge. And where the big change happened there, where there was another running boom in the 80s, New York Marathon was growing and everything, was, and so we had this one. But what I will tell you is the big difference came in the early 90s, when women and charities both at the same time, which when you think about it, it made sense because the charities were really pushing a lot of runners to the marathon, and majority of those charity runners were female. And so now suddenly it was, you know, more acceptable. The shoe companies and apparel companies were making products for women, and little by little, the women started growing into the sport. Until now, you go to a half marathon and even marathons, it's often 55-45% female, sometimes 60-40 female. And so, quite honestly, women getting into the sport back in the 90s really helped to propel the sport and bring us to where we are with the numbers today.
Okay, what's your vision about this competitor stuff of running rock and roll marathon, putting down the elite program?
Well, I'm sad that they did. I, you know, as a former, you know, distance runner myself, I wish we could keep more of that, particularly here in the US, because there's not a lot of races, particularly where the US runners can make a living with their sport. That's the emotional side for me. I wish they would continue or could continue. I do understand, particularly on the business side, I do understand why they did that. There's unfortunately not a lot of return, if you will, for that. As much as running's grown, I still think in a lot of ways it's looked at more for the numbers and wow, isn't that amazing? All these people out there running, and for whatever reason, it's not taken as seriously as a sport, and particularly in this country, as far as, of course, football, basketball, baseball, and so it's not carried so much on the serious sports side. So that I do understand why they did it. I just wish they could continue. We're adding some prize money to our races, though, I will say that.
So, John, how do you improve your races? I mean, in Brazil, we have some specific problems, like we don't see any curves there of
Right.
pacing or even pacers.
And how do you improve your races? You see, you get feedback from the runners and strike. Yeah. You were a decent runner yourself, so how do you handle this?
No, that's a good question. I think it does help a lot that I continue to run, and I do go to other races here in the U.S. and even outside the U.S. And so do our staff. And so you always see what other people are doing. You know, what you like, what you don't like. You can maybe bring back and improve your own event. As the events did begin to grow and get very large in this country to the 20, 30, 40,000 person events, we started to realize that crowd control and crowd management was now just as much a part of the event as anything else. So we even go to the experts on, you know, public safety and so forth, and there's been a lot of studies done, and we also share a lot of best practices. I go up to Chicago, we have a program during the summer with the Chicago Marathon, and they share a lot. And at a lot of the major races, they have race director programs. And again, we share and we learn best practices from each other.
3, 2, 1, go!
When do you guys start doing Walt Disney events? Because this is huge right now, yeah?
Yeah.
Loads of Brazilians coming here to run.
Yes, Brazil has taken over as our number one foreign country, which is fantastic. It started, back in 92, I began talking with Disney and had told them earlier that it would be a great place for a destination marathon. Took a couple of years of convincing and research, and you know, they're a big company.
Yeah.
And in January 94, we had our first Walt Disney World Marathon. And the marathon was by itself for a few years, and then we added the half. And of course, in the last 10 years, we've slowly added some other events. Well, I shouldn't say slowly. In the last 5 years, we've had a lot of events. So we now have 5 events here in Florida and 2 events out in California, and it's gotten to be huge. They sell out now very quickly.
So how much a runner are you right now? Because you said you were an elite runner. How good were you?
Oh, you know, yeah. No, I didn't. You said I was elite. I didn't say I was elite.
No, I'm saying right now.
No.
Okay.
I mean, I ran in college and I did run open for a little while. I ran a 2:34 marathon.
Okay. This is
you
nice,
know,
man.
It was, but back then that was just okay, and it still is really just okay, but you know, I enjoyed it. I got very busy shortly after that with the, you know, business and then the family, so it was all good. It was fun at the time.
Most of your staff at the races are runners too, as just like the store,
the
staff of the your races.
Oh, we have two very separate businesses.
I know,
right?
But is the staff who do we work that work with you at the races are runners as well?
Oh, yes, you're correct. We have everybody here at the store runs, and with our event business, they all run, you know, most of them for fun and okay. Fitness. There's a couple that still like to compete, but yeah, most for fun and fitness.
All right. Yeah. We're done, John.
Good.